Good morning, gang. I'm glad you're all here. Hope you're enjoying your weekend. I normally don't post smaller earthquakes that happen up there in Alaska, but I found some additional real interesting information, and so I thought I would share it with you. There was a 4.2 earthquake at about 4:58 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So far, 79 people said they felt it. This was a deep earthquake. 67 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level, or 108 kilometers deep. This was an earthquake that was caused by the subduction of the Pacific plate going under the North American plate, close to an area where there was a 6.0 in 2014. And we'll bring it out. Over here we have Anchorage. There's a Castle Mountain Fault. And then over here on the eastern side, that is the location of the earthquake they had in 1964, which was a magnitude 9.2. Some of the felt reports sent in to EMSC, this one's from Anchorage, said it was a short shake. Another one from Anchorage, bump and short shake. A light shake for about a minute from Anchorage. One from the Air Force Base, the Elmendorf Air Force Base, which is about 76 miles southeast from where the earthquake occurred, said they felt a light, gentle shaking, a jiggle for about 20 seconds. They didn't hear any noise. So they didn't hear the first wave of the earthquake, which would have been the P wave. Eagle River said they felt a slight shake on the house two times. Another one from Eagle River said very light movement, but lasted several seconds. Going to the stream view, here we have Berry Arm Glacier. I want to go into that one, the information that I found. The middle one is Tana Glacier, and the other one, Tanalina, Alaska. So the strongest shaking of the monitors came from the Berry Arm Glacier. You can see it there, and there's another one there. And then up here, which is a stronger signature, Tanalina, Alaska, for that first quake. The magnitude that I get from the glacier, and it's a ways away, and it shouldn't matter as long as you got the full extent of the seismic wave, was actually smaller. I got a 3.8, and they're saying it's 4.2. But yeah, you can see we got subduction. We'll go to the signature. Yeah, long P wave, because it is a ways from it. But there's been a lot of shaking over there. You can see we got several marked in red. We got this one. And we'll go to the spectrogram. 505, and then we got another one. Let me pull it over. At, within last night, Universal Time. This is all Universal Time. 21:27. Which I do not see anywhere on this map. There's another one over here. This one, too, has got a long P wave on it. Perry, Alaska had an earthquake at 5:47. Let me bring this over. So they are not reporting these that I showed you. Once again, more than likely, it's the need to know, what they feel you need to know. Yeah, that they're reporting and not reporting. I want to take a look at the signature. This is actually two earthquakes. Yeah. And that one's at 21:27. All right, so I want to go to Berry Arm Alaska Glacier. That's the one monitor right there. They have monitors that they put up right along this ridge. That's how the earthquake came in at Berry Arm. Not too long of a P wave on it. They evidently had to go up there last year to clear off the snow that had accumulated on the solar panels. There's evidently an ongoing hazard for a landslide for that area and for the fishing vessels that might go out in that area. And they've been monitoring what's going on. They hope to have a tsunami warning system put up there, but currently they don't have that. If you happen to be in a boat, you would probably only have 10 to 20 minutes to get out of that harbor or bay. Let me show you again. Because of a landslide, here it is. This is Barry Arm. And then we'll bring it out. And we'll bring it out. And we'll bring it out. Over here we have Cook Inlet. If you are on land or tied at a dock, do not attempt to take your vessel offshore. Leave your boat and go to higher ground on foot as soon as possible. You do not have time to save your boat in this situation and put your life and potential lives of others at risk if you try to do so. If you are in deep water or very close to deep water, take your vessel further offshore beyond the minimum offshore safety depth of at least 30 fathoms or 180 feet. If you are on the water but very near shore, use your best judgment to decide between two options. So remember, you're going to have 10 to 20 minutes after an earthquake or the landslide from this area. Safely beach, dock the vessel, and evacuate to higher ground, or go beyond the minimum offshore safety depth of 30 fathoms, 180 feet. Attempting to beach the vessel could be challenging and dangerous, depending on wave conditions, coastlines and terrain, water levels, and the presence of sandbars. It is easy for a boat to run aground or capsize before reaching shore, only then to be swept away by the incoming tsunami. They have a picture of Dennis Stanley from USGS adjusting the radar site camera, it says here. Evidently, there's no roads to this area, and they used a helicopter to get in. And they got more images. Yeah, there's the solar panels. Repeater station, lightning rod with Rhine. So that is evidently the lightning rod. And the different locations for the repeater stations. I thought it was interesting. View of the Barry Arm landslide and toe of Barry Glacier with Cascade Glacier in left foreground, it says. Now, this was posted February 2nd of this year, 2022. Now, I noticed somewhere on here it said of last year, but it said they went up there in February to clear the solar panels and realign the cameras. Okay, here's where I got the 2021 date from. It says the National Tsunami Warning Center installed water level gauges during the extreme low tide last week in April of 2021. But the warning system is not yet operational. So February must be the month where they go up there every year and do maintenance. It said here that they put in an infrasound array at Whittier in early February of 2021. And then they have a page here about the Barry Arm landslide and tsunami hazard. A large steep slope in the Barry Arm, 30 miles northeast of Whittier, Alaska. So let's go to that location right there. All right, it's close. It's right on the water. Yeah, okay. Has the potential to fall into the water and generate a tsunami that could have devastating local effects on those who live, work, and recreate in and around Whittier and in the northern Prince William Sound. At this time, there is no way to know when, if, or how much of the slope may fall into the water. So they put in the reliable early warning and rapid detection system for the potential of the risk from a Barry Arm landslide and tsunami. We strongly encourage that you take this threat seriously and avoid this part of Prince William Sound. day off this slope, rockfall have been observed in this area. Please heed U.S. Coast Guard safety information and remember, your natural early warning signs for a tsunami may be your best and only alert. Yeah, you hear a strange rumble or a roar. You see water withdrawal or advance in unusual distance and have a very strong earthquake in that location. So let's zoom in. Yeah, they got a lot of boats there. Look at that. Alaska.org's got a webpage showing the harbor. Some of the boats. And they're promoting tourism there. You can take a day cruise in the Prince William Sound to see glaciers, whales, sea otters, bobbing in the water, and seals hauled out on ice chunks that have calved from the glacier. Yeah. Kind of have to tell you, you know, you laugh about these tourist information. You know, they're telling you to, yeah, stay out of the area. You just don't know when it's going to happen. But it says here, even better, the waters of Prince William Sound here are protected and calm. Day cruises in other areas of Alaska are often closer to open water, making for a potentially rougher outing. And larger vessels here, like the 26th Glacier Cruise, come with a no seasickness guarantee. And these are all the earthquakes within the last 24 hours that have been recorded there in that bay. Yeah, look at them all. And then earlier there was tectonic plate movement. That's what, let me go back over here. That's what this is here. Got a small earthquake there. Let me try and pull that. So you can see that small earthquake right there. And let me pull that information. All right. Those of you that follow me will know that these sharper seismic waves, that is tectonic. Now, if it was rounded, that would indicate volcanic magma movement. But when you got the sharper points, that is tectonic plate movement. We got subduction going on all along the Aleutian Islands where the Pacific plate is subducting underneath the North American plate. And the North American plate actually wraps up around, yeah, up over here. Yeah. So something that I stumbled upon, maybe God wanted me to know this stuff, I don't know. I find the strangest things at the strangest times. So what are your thoughts? Please put that information down below. Put your questions down below. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.